I am a warrior and member of a team. I serve the people of the United States and live the Army, Marine, Navy, Air Force, and Coast Guard values. I will always place the mission first, never accept defeat, never quit, and never leave a friend behind. Today we're here to honor those who come close to having been left behind without a family and without their honors. There's a lot of stories covering each one of these men or women. We don't know what they are. We do know that they did serve honorably at one point in their lives, and that's what we're here to honor them for. They help to keep this country strong. They help to keep this country free, regardless of their duties, regardless of their assignments, regardless of wherever they went in this world. We're going to see how my new lens does work. Today, from Los Angeles, Bruce Schmidt, United States Army, Cold War, age 52. Lauren Reese, United States Army, Vietnam, age 64. Richard Johnson, United States Army, Cold War, age 55. Bernard Cadden, honorably served, age 69. Archer Byars, U.S. Army, World War II, age 89. William Penrock, Jr., U.S. Army, World War II, age 85. Kenneth Seay, United States Army, Vietnam, age 70. Rudyard Bowman, United States Army, age 78, Cold War. Also brought for honor today are those who were brought for direct burial from counties throughout the Southern California area with no families to render honors. Today we are honoring Walter Evans, U.S. Army. Tom Grip, U.S. Navy. Joseph Santolito, United States Navy. Albert Foster, U.S. Navy. Donald Herbert, U.S. Navy. Emery Covington, U.S. Army. Edward Weber, U.S. Army. Mario Contadino, Air Force. Richard Franklin, Army. John Quinlan, U.S. Navy. Audrey Clark, United States Army Air Force. Actually, that's United States Army Air Corps, so it was before World War II. Audrey Clark, U.S. Navy. Marion Rock, U.S. Army. William Brennan, U.S. Army. And Richard Grant, U.S. Navy.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Let me first of all thank all of you for being here. Personally, it's good to see all of you. We're here to pay tribute to all those that have been mentioned this morning. The tribute is to pay honor to them, but the tribute belongs to you. When God created man, he created man in his image. That image includes the compassion that we all have towards another person. It includes the understanding of what they may have gone through prior to their decease. Also has the respect of those who have served. And as I was going through the book of Romans the other night, and knowing that I was going to be here today, I found a verse that I think is very appropriate. It shows what we're talking about and the reason we're here today. It's in Romans 1:12. It's called encouragement. We may be mutual strengthened and encouraged and comforted to each one. And that's what you're doing today, is you're strengthening the compassion, the love, the respect, and the honor that you show to each other, but also to those who have gone before us. When an individual puts on the uniform, he raises his right hand and he says, "I will, whatever cost." A lot of us from the Vietnam era saw over 58,000 of our individual brothers and sisters give up their lives so that we could stand here today as free people to honor those who've gone before us and to pay tribute to those who are coming up behind us. I think it's kind of a natural thing, an inherent thing for all of us to be compassionate. But I also think that as you're standing here today to pay the tribute to these individuals, thousands of those who've gone before us, shows me that you have the compassion that God has designed you with. As we remember those who have passed, let us also remember a couple of our brothers who have gone to surgery. George Simmons, for example, went to surgery. I talked to him the other night, and for a person who's going basically under the knife, not knowing but hoping the results will be very positive and life-saving, I'd like to lift him up in prayer this morning as we pray for everyone else. If you uncover. Dear God, we are thankful that we're able to stand here today and pay tribute to those who've gone before us. We're thankful, Lord, that you have put doctors in our place that help us recover from those things that we suffer. But we're thankful, Lord, that we have a country that still believes in the freedom of man. And for those who have raised their hand to defend that freedom, we lift up to you and ask you, bless not only those who are coming to you, Lord, but those who are here serving you, Lord. We know that you're loving, caring, and comforting God. Place your hand upon each person here, and as we leave this morning, make the road safe. Let everybody have a blessed day. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.
Amen.
Thank you all.
Thank you, Reverend Bob. It's been quite a while since we've heard your voice giving the word out up here, but it's sure nice to hear it again.
August 12, 1943. Dear Mom, Dad, and Jean, I guess I should have written sooner, but I have been pretty busy so far this week. Mostly, we've been going to school and doing all kinds of other stuff. It all keeps me going pretty fast. This morning, we fired the Browning automatic rifle, and I happened to place my shots pretty good, so they made me a B-A-R bar man. If anybody knows what that is, please tell me. I don't know whether I'm going to like it or not. The darn thing weighs 20 pounds compared to our regular rifle. That'll be some fun lugging this thing on a hike. I like it out here a lot better than I did at the base. They keep me busy, and it's better than just fooling around all the time. I guess I must be going to be sent to some island because they issued us a camouflage poncho. I hope I get the money from you soon before Saturday so I can come home on the bus. If I don't get it before then, I'm going to have to hitchhike. I guess I would probably make it just about as fast that way, though. I haven't heard from anyone around town for a couple of weeks, so I don't know what's going on. I heard Alex Sim was killed. Is that right? Has the dog been around lately? I hope he's home this weekend if I can get there. Well, I don't have anything more to say, so I better stop. I have to recopy some notes in my notebook, too. Bye for now. I'll see you Saturday, I hope. Love, Jack.
Thank you.
Thank you.
If we cannot do him honor while he's here to hear the praise, then at least let's give him homage at the ending of his days. Perhaps just a simple headline in a paper that would say, "Our country is in mourning. A soldier died today." Thank you for being here.